All right. Well, let's go to New York City, and we'll talk with Chris. Hey, Chris, you're on the air. We got just a few minutes left. What's on your mind tonight?
Hey, Andrew. Actually, it's I'm in Buffalo, New York area.
Oh, okay. Buffalo. Great.
BDCX, yeah. In between, we have a Bible study at church, and the topic came up, if a Christian commits suicide, that they're going to go to hell. Mm-hmm. And I believe that, you know, Jesus, he came to heal the broken. And I don't think there's anybody that's more broken than somebody that's, you know, at a point where they're going to take their own life.
Right.
The argument came up that, you know, then they don't have hope or they don't believe in Jesus. You know, they're not really saved if they're able to be driven to that point. Okay. I'm just trying to find if there's any supporting scripture, because if the person mm-hmm. who brought it up, he's fairly solid with his... Mm-hmm. You know, most of what he believes in the Bible, but something doesn't feel right. But can you clear that up?
Yeah, well, it doesn't feel right because it's not right. I mean, I think you're right to suspect there and to throw up a red flag of concern, my friend. I mean, you know, in the history of this world, has there ever been a true believer that has been in such despair or mental anguish or had mental illness going on to such a degree that they took their own life? Well, of course. So to say that that can't happen to a Christian, that that's not a true Christian, I mean, what a blow. That's kicking somebody when they're down. And then that's saying that God kicks people when they're down. I mean, here's somebody, let's say a teenager, they prayed to receive Christ and really meant it. They understood the gospel. They received Jesus. And then they go through a hard time. Who knows? The death of their parents, the divorce of their parents, something else goes on big time. They end up in jail. I mean, they're depressed. They get to the place where the enemy accuses them. They take their own life. And then, well, this guy's going to say, so they go to hell? I mean, so apparently, you know, God says, I forgive you of all your sins. They're taken away as far as the east is from the west, unless you get really depressed and commit suicide. I have forgiven you. Your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgotten. I remember your sins no more. Unless you get really down and the enemy accuses you and you commit suicide, then it's off. All bets are off. The deal is over. You see how absurd that is, how pathetic that is. You know, people are trying to quote out of 1 John chapter 5 about the sin that leads to death, and, you know, that's suicide and we shouldn't pray about that and all this stuff. Well, the sin that leads to death, it's a spiritual death that John is talking about. In 1 John chapter 5, he says, if you see any brother or sister commit a sin that does not lead to death, you should pray, and God will give them life. He says, I refer to those whose sin does not lead to death. There is a sin that leads to death. I'm not saying you should pray about that. So what's he talking about there? What's the only sin that leads to spiritual death? Well, it's unbelief in the gospel, rejecting Jesus, rejecting his identity, rejecting the cross, rejecting the resurrection. Unbelief in Jesus, unbelief in the gospel, is the sin that leads to death. We remain under God's wrath if we reject the gospel. So why wouldn't we pray about that? Well, we can't pray somebody into the kingdom because they have a will. They have a chooser. They can choose to accept or reject the message of the gospel. So I can't pray you into the kingdom. You can't pray me into the kingdom. We can pray for open doors, that the gospel would be there, that I would be exposed to it, that you would, that our friends would. And so, sure, we can pray that as Paul and others prayed that, but we cannot pray people into the kingdom because God will not circumvent their will. They have to choose. After hearing, they have to choose to believe. So that's why John is saying you can't pray about a sin that leads to spiritual death, the sin of rejecting the gospel, because you can't overcome someone's choice. Nevertheless, there's all kinds of other sins that don't lead to spiritual death, and we can pray all day long about those things because Christ has already cleaned house and moved in to the lives of those people, and Christ is working in the midst of that, and they've given him permission to work in their lives, so we can pray all day long about those matters. The Spirit of God lives in those people. So, you know, Chris, I hope that helps. You know, it breaks my heart when people go to 1 John 5 or even just generically say that every sin is forgiven except suicide. I mean, nowhere in the Scriptures is that found? And so it's just make-believe. It's fantasy. And we need to come back to the reality of the gospel, that the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us of all sin, not some sin, not 99% of sin, but all sin. And so the truth of the gospel is that the finished work of Christ resulted in us being completely forgiven of past sins, present sins, and future sins. That is the beauty of the gospel, and quite frankly, it's that forgiveness that inspires us to live uprightly.